Warriors, is XRP Ripple taking over the payment system? We're going to show you facts, figures, numbers, and logic. My name is Coach JV. I am the top health, mindset, and crypto coach in the world. What you believe in your heart, you think in your mind, will eventually become your words and become your reality. If you can see it in your mind, eventually you can hold it right here in your hands. What you repeatedly do gets ingrained in your subconscious mind. What gets ingrained in your subconscious mind becomes an unconscious activity. Now, Warriors, if you've not joined the Private Warrior Academy, as of this morning, the brand new Crypto Academy is launched. So if you're starting out in crypto or you need support in crypto, so what do we offer? A cryptocurrency course, detail, DeFi, staking, how to use the cryptocurrency apps, how to use the wallets. We're not financial advisors, just documenting our journey. What is it? How to do it? And an example, 5 calls per week. We have our 120-day challenge to help you get your shit together, subconscious mind programming, goal setting, vision board creation. There's nothing like it on the planet. Click description down below before the price goes up. Now that it's launched, we'll be launching the new price in the next week. So make sure you get on board now. All right, so we're going to kick it right off. First of all, I want to give a big shout out to the Bearable Bull. He did a video on this as well, pointing out our Bank XRP's Twitter. And he comes up with the greatest videos. He finds these amazing, amazing, amazing videos. Okay. So this was on October 29th, 2021. So big shout out to Bearable Bull. I saw his video last night. And then I went, you guys know, I just freaking dove down the rabbit hole because I'd love to see these things because it's nice to see facts, figures, numbers, logic when we find this information, right? So Bank XRP, if you want to see this video or you want to use it on your channel, just make sure you give him a shout out. Okay, so we're going to play this video right here. So now this is the CEO of Identity, okay? Now they talk about the Ripple and Swift partnership. Now I've been telling you guys that Ripple is going to take over the payment system and the banking system for a very long time. Here's what I think is going to happen. Ripple XRP is going to be for the institutions and the banks. XLM is going to be for the consumers, right? Jen McCaleb started XLM. Behind the scenes, they say there's this battle between XLM and XRP. But I think what happened is he went over there to start XLM so they could take over the consumer side. That's why MoneyGram left XRP or Ripple specifically to go over to XLM as XRP and Ripple take over the banking and payment system on the consumer side, right? The decentralized side, like the Venmo, that type of side, like, you know, MoneyGram, things like that. So that's why that relationship over there, just my opinion, we're all making the best guess we can. So we're gonna watch this video, we're gonna hear it from the CEO's mouth, and then I'm gonna show you facts, figures, numbers, logic through patents and investor meetings as well. So let's go ahead and take a listen.
Your share price spiked briefly above 30 cents. It's now around that 18 cent mark. What caused the spike and why wasn't it able to be maintained?
If I'm honest with the market, the spike came from some public discussion about the patents that we own in the United States and drawing some connections with what our patent could be used for. We made it public that our patent for an idea that uses blockchain and tokens to send and receive very rich payment information around the world has the ability to connect both old and new payment networks around the world. So for the transmission of payment messages, we could be connecting members of the Swift network with members of the Ripple network.
Boom. Did you hear what he just said? So their price spike in their stock went up because they have patented technology that brings Ripple and Swift together, working together. I've told you, they're all going to work together. We've seen the ISO 20022 document. They came up with a patent that allows them to marry together, to work together to change the payment system. Think about this, Warriors. The government they need Ripple. They need Swift. If they didn't need Ripple or XRP, they wouldn't have used Swift. Swift is not a government organization, Warriors. Think about that. Swift is a private and public sector coming together. Now we're doing it in a cryptocurrency type of way. This gentleman from Identity created a patent to bring them together. Okay, so let's look at the facts, figures, numbers, logic. So if we look back here, this is an investor presentation in 2018. So this is Identity. So this is 2018. So what I like to do is I always hit Command F and then I pull up Ripple, right? If you go here, it's beautiful to see these documents here. It says the market landscape. You got your APIs, you got Identity, you got Corda. Does that sound familiar? You got Ethereum, Hyperledger, so that's the blockchain protocols, okay? You got Equinix, VPN, proxy. You got Azure, AWS, Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud, Ali Cloud. Then in the payment rails, so this is how this are you ho- hopefully you're seeing this. They're all working together behind the scenes. They're not against each other. They're working together with each other. So you have Swift, ACH, okay? You have RTGS and Ripple working together. These four changing your payment system. So Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud, Ali Cloud, and Azure are changing the environment. The communication is through VPN, proxy, and Equinix. The blockchain protocols is Corda, Ethereum, and Hyperledger. That's what I've always been so bullish on Ethereum. Identity is the application, and Identity has the API keys to connect these companies very quickly and efficiently. Okay, so that's the first part with Ripple here. If you look at the competitive landscape marketing infrastructure, so you have JP Morgan. Now we're going to go and look at the ISO 20022 document at the end. R3's in there, right? You got Swift, you got Ripple, you got R3, you got Corda. All these things are mentioned in here, Warriors. Are you starting to see that this is all going to come together? They're not going to be going against each other. They're going to work together to change the financial system. So this is the competitive landscape. We know the JP Morgan, the one that tells you cryptocurrency is a fraud, tells you that Bitcoin is completely worthless. They have their own DLT, their distributed ledger technology. They have the JPM coin. You got the Swift system, right? So they say they're competing against business that they're competing, but what their technology does is it starts to bring all this stuff together. So existing and emerging networks are improving payment rails. You got Swift and Ripple. And if you can marry, be the company that marries the two together, you literally monopolize the market. Okay. So that's one of their investor presentations from 2018 that I'm going to show you the 2021. Okay. All right, so this is a 2021 document that came out. This was on, Bank XRP's Twitter as well. So I found the investor presentation. So if you take a look at this, it's on page 10, Identity's concept of globally connecting ecosystems, granted U.S. patent. They've been granted the U.S. patent, okay? U.S. PTO granted 2021, recognizing a global connected ecosystem for rich tokenized payment information, accessibility via enterprise blockchain, universally compatible with legacy networks such as Swift and ACH, and new networks such as RippleNet, MasterCard, cross-border payment services. And we know that MasterCard and XRP have linked up. There's a MasterCard that you can get XRP rewards on. Words. This is all happening behind the scenes as you're getting flooded out of the marketplace. The Ripple SEC lawsuit is all for a new Howey test. That's all it is, words. Okay, so here's the actual patent. If you want to take a deep dive into it, you can take a look. You can pull all this stuff up. So it's computer implemented method for processing financial transactions in a system. Therefore, this was the one that was submitted, I think, in 2018. So let's dive into the document here. Okay, so let's go to the top of the document. So this is the actual patent. Okay, this is the United States patent application, and this is Identity. Okay, this is their patent, and this I think this one has been approved. I don't know if this is the one that's been approved. I believe so. Or maybe this is the one that's been approved in the US. So this was put in 2018. And I think maybe this is the one that they just approved just recently, or that document. Or maybe that video is an old video during this time. But what we do know is this is already approved. The patent's been approved. Okay. So don't quote me on that. That video may have been an old video from back, kind of reminding us of what's happening. Okay. But take a look at this. So the patent was filed in August 2016, right? And everybody thinks that cryptocurrency, all this stuff is brand new coming out. This has been going on for a very long time. MIT has been working on cryptography. Is it MIT? For a very, very long time. Okay. So what I do is I type in Ripple here on the patent. Let's take a deep dive here. Okay. So it's all over this patent. Ripple. Okay. Some of the things it says here, the framework, Ripple, the framework thereby facilitating sustainable real-time cross-border payments, multiple institutions, and multiple banks. Okay, blockchains can be based on operating in association with one of the number of protocols, for example, Ripple or Stellar. I told you guys, Stellar, I didn't even notice that. XLM's in here as well. They're all working together, where settlement gateway pairs, banks send, by the way of non-limiting example, XRP, the native currency of Ripple protocol, to billers banks gateways, payers bank gateways, notifies token base 1023 of receipt. Okay, just keeps going on. Embodiment of the invention, or it, yeah, invention can be implemented unlisting the Ripple framework. Okay, so there's Ripple. I didn't even know XLM was in this. That's even better. So let's go over here and let's type in Swift. Okay, this is boom. Swift, right there, Bank B, it shows you all of this stuff. They created a system or a patent that connects the old archaic banking system, which is Swift system, to the new up and running system. I mean, it's all over the place. Oh, it's beautiful words. I love going through this stuff. I must be a nerd, but you got Swift, you got ACH, and that was the document we saw in the investor presentation. They basically came up with a patent that connects all this stuff together. So the banks needs this. The bank needs this to survive, right? Okay, so you got RTGS right there. You got Swift. I mean, you can go through all this stuff yourself, okay? And you go in here, you got, oh, this is so much fun. Provide comparison characteristics, embodiments of the present in invention of compared with the prior art Swift based messaging system. So they're just revamping the old system, okay? Allowing old technology and new technology come together. Let's type in Stellar and see what happens there. Is that the only time they're mentioned? Well, why would they mention in there, right? So you have XLM. Yeah, I it's funny that I mentioned that in the beginning. I didn't even realize that. So for example, Ripple or Stellar. Stellar is going to be more for the consumer side. XRP Ripple is going to be for the institutional side. All right, so let's show you this document again, just to remind you and bring you back to balanced understanding of the fundamentals of cryptocurrency. Okay, sorry, this is kind of a fuzzy document here. So we got Stellar, we got R3. Does that sound familiar? You got Corda. Does that sound familiar? Ripple, right? You got Swift, you got JP Morgan, Algorand, Circle, Accenture, Consensus, we got IBM, R3, Warriors. It's all here. Everything's here for you. R3, Swift, Ripple, JP Morgan. I mean, how much more can we see? How much more can we see, Warriors? Swift, ACH, we got Crossbow, RippleNet. I mean, it's everywhere, Warriors. This is powerful, powerful stuff. So it's hidden in plain sight. It's absolutely hidden in plain sight. So for people to think that Ripple XRP is this token that's just going to disappear or go away, do you realize how deep this is in the financial system? How big this is going to be? I mean, Ripple has been working with the SEC since its inception. Think about that. One of the only cryptocurrency protocols that met with the SEC frequently since its inception. But for some reason, we have an SEC lawsuit against Ripple. That's why I don't let go, Warriors. I've had many people in the recent past not only start getting shaky about XRP. And remember, XRP is always the last to go in the bull cycle. Always the last to go in the bull cycle. But if you're focused on just getting rich right now, you're always going to get wrecked. I don't care if it goes parabolic during this bull cycle. I'm in it for the long-term, Warriors. People recently have reached out to me, multiple people, well, quite a few people actually, close to 10 about Stellar XL. I'm like, I'm out. I'm bouncing. If you don't have patience in this market, Warriors, if you're in it for the short term, you're always going to get wrecked. You're going to make emotional decisions. That's why you need to have an exit plan. For example, at this point right now on this date, I think it's the 15th of November, 2021. Everybody's like, oh, what if it doesn't go parabolic? Then it doesn't. I don't exercise my exit plan. I hold my cryptocurrencies long term. Because Warriors, the fact is most people are patient enough to be in a shitty relationship for year after year, patient enough to be in a horrible job that they hate year after year, patient enough to be overweight and not do anything about it year after year, patient enough to be broke year after year after year, patient enough to be manipulated by the boss year after year after year. But people are not patient enough to wait a year, 2 years, 3 years to amass more wealth than they've ever amassed in their life. It's time to create patience, persistence, discipline, understanding of macro and microeconomics, and the fact that you're invested in the new shift of your economic system, Warriors. So you got to develop that emotional intelligence. And that's what we help in our Warrior Academy. I'm going to keep talking. I'm very proud about the Warrior Academy, Warriors, because it's changing people's lives. There is nothing like it. 120-day challenge, subconscious mind programming, goal setting, vision board creation, new exercises. We have yoga instructors. We have mindset. Then we just launched our brand new Crypto Academy. And it was amazing before with the connections and the calls for crypto and the generational wealth calls. And on Thursday, we'll basically deep dive crypto call. We have guest speakers. But then we just added, launched last night, coming into this morning, our brand new cryptocurrency courses because we got feedback from our clients. Well, it's great I get on a call, but how do I do it? So it's what is it, how to do it, and an example, Warriors. We're doing the best we can to bring you the information so you don't get flooded out of the marketplace. Remember, we are not financial advisors. I am not a financial advisor. None of this is financial advice. We are just all documenting our journey into the quantum financial system. We want to be here to support you, Warriors, so that you can become one of the wealthiest, richest people in the world and change the narrative. As we always say, Warriors! Ah, let's get your shit together. Let's go.